गुड मॉर्निंग एवरी वन, माई सेल्फ इज किरण माई, लेक्चरर इन फिजिक्स वर्किंग एट गवर्नमेंट सिटी कॉलेज. टुडे नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द स्टैटिस्टिकल मैकेनिक्स. नाउ कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ स्टैटिस्टिकल मैकेनिक्स. टू द एंड ऑफ 17th सेंचुरी द फिजिकल फिनोमेना वेर एक्सप्लेन्ड विद द हेल्प ऑफ ऑर्डिनरी लॉस ऑफ मैकेनिक्स. Consider the following situations in which the system consists of a large number of particles. First one, consider the case of gas consisting of 10 power 23 molecules. In order to obtain the complete information concerning the motion of the system, we have to solve 10 power 23 equations of motion or more. Moreover, it is not possible to have a complete knowledge regarding these positions and velocities of all the molecules. Therefore, it is impossible to apply the ordinary laws of mechanics to such a physical system. Consider the problem of an atom with two electrons present in it. Consider its behavior. No one has solved it completely by the use of ordinary laws of mechanics. Therefore, it is impossible to solve the problem of a system consisting of a large number of particles with the help of ordinary laws of mechanics. Such problems have been successfully solved by the method of statistical mechanics. Statistical mechanics is a branch of science which establishes the relation between the macroscopic behavior of the system in terms of its microscopic behavior. So, statistical mechanics, as its name implies, it's not concerned with the actual motion of individual particles of the system, but investigates the most probable behavior or statistical properties of assembly of particles. Methods to study the statistical mechanics can be classified mainly in two categories. First one is classical statistics or Maxwell-Boltzmann statistics and quantum statistics, which is subdivided into two categories: Bose-Einstein statistics and Fermi-Dirac statistics. Now, the classical statistics utilizes the classical results of Maxwell's law of distribution of molecular velocities. The Maxwell-Boltzmann statistics successfully explains the phenomenon like temperature, pressure, energy, etc. of a gas, but fails to explain experimentally observed facts like black body radiation, photoelectric effect, specific heat at low temperature, etc. For explaining such phenomenon, the quantum statistics was developed by Bose-Einstein, Fermi and Dirac. One form of quantum statistics is known as Bose-Einstein statistics and other form is known as Fermi-Dirac statistics. The particles obeying Bose-Einstein statistics are known as bosons. The examples are protons, neutral helium atoms in ground state, and alpha particles. The particles obeying Fermi-Dirac statistics are known as fermions. The examples are of protons, electrons, neutrons, etc. The statistical equilibrium. Consider a thermodynamical isolated system consists of n particles. Let the energy states available to these particles having energies E1, E2, so on up to En. Suppose that at any given instant of time, N1 particles are in state 1, N2 particles are in energy state E2, and so on. Now, capital N equals to N1 plus N2 plus N3 plus so on up to summation Ni. U equals to N1 E1 plus N2 E2 plus N3 E3, so on, summation Ni Ei, where U is the energy of the system. Here, it is assumed that the particles are non-interacting and the total energy U is constant. We know that the molecules of a gas collide with each other and also with the walls of the container. As a result, N1, N2, N3, so on continuously changing. The reason is that there is a transition of molecules from one energy state to other energy state. It is reasonably assumed that for each state of the system, there is a particular most favored distribution. Now, when this distribution is reached, the system attains equilibrium known as statistical equilibrium. Statistical equilibrium. Before considering statistical equilibrium, we would like to introduce the terms ensemble, phase points, and phase space, and density of distribution in phase space. First one is ensemble. An ensemble may be defined as collection of a very large number of assemblies which are essentially independent of another, but they are made macroscopically as identical as possible. Here, macroscopically identical means that each assembly is characterized by the same values of set of macroscopic parameters which uniquely determine the equilibrium state of the assembly. Next is phase points and phase space. In classical mechanics, the position of a particle is described in terms of three Cartesian coordinates, x, y, z. The particle is said to have 3 degrees of freedom. The state of motion of a particle is described in terms of velocity components dx by dt, dy by dt, dz by dt, or vx, vy, vz. The position r of a point in coordinates x, y, z is shown in figure. Sometimes it is more convenient to use momentum coordinates px, py, pz instead of velocity coordinates. Here m refers to the mass of the particle. Thus, the position of a single particle can be specified in terms of Cartesian coordinates x, y, z and its correspond momentum components px, py, pz. This shows that 6 coordinates are needed to specify a one particle system completely. Gibbs suggested that any instantaneous state of a particle may be conveniently represented by imagining a 6-dimensional space in which the 6 coordinates are marked along 6 mutually perpendicular axes in space. This is purely a mathematical concept. The 6-dimensional space is known as phase space or mu space. A point in the phase space representing the instantaneous state of the particle is called a phase point. As the time progresses, the phase point moves in the phase space and its motion is called a trajectory of the particle. The number of phase points per unit volume is called the phase density of these points. The phase space can be divided into a large number of elemental cells. Each of the volume delta x, delta y, delta z, delta px, delta py, delta pz. Such an elemental cell is called as phase cell. Density of distribution in phase space. The condition of an ensemble at any time can be specified by the density function rho with which the phase points are distributed in phase space. The density function rho is also called as density of distribution or probability density or distribution function. The density function rho is a function of f, position coordinates q1, q2, so on up to qf, and f momentum coordinates p1, p2, so on up to pf, corresponding to 2f combined position momentum axis in phase space. The density of distribution rho is also a function of time because at any time the density will change due to the motion of phase points in phase space. Rho equals to rho into q1, q2, q so on up to qf, p1, p2, so on up to pf, t. That is rho of q, p, t. The significance of density of distribution is that it denotes the number of systems which are found at any given time in a given small volume of a space. We can follow this statistical equilibrium. Next is statistical equilibrium. An ensemble is said to be in statistical equilibrium if it obeys the following two conditions. The probabilities of finding face points in various regions of face should be independent of time. The average values for the properties of the system in the ensemble should also be independent of time. Mathematically, the conditions of an ensemble in statistical equilibrium can be expressed as rho by dou t at q comma p equals to 0. The equation shows that for an ensemble to be in statistical equilibrium, the density rho must be independent of time at all points in phase space. Therefore, we conclude that if rho is a function of some property of the ensemble which is independent of time, the ensemble will be in statistical equilibrium. Next is statistical equilibrium and most probable distribution. Consider an isolated thermodynamical system containing n particles. The energy states available to the particles are E1, E2, E3, so on, etc. Let at any instant of time N1 particles be in energy state E1, N2 particles are in energy state E2. The total number of particles in the system is n equals to n1 plus n2 plus so on summation ni. The total energy of the system is u equals to n1 e1 plus n2 e2 plus n3 e3 so on, that is summation of ni ei. The equation 2 gives the total energy of the system in which the particles are non-interacting. Further, the energy of each particle depends on the coordinates of that particle alone. As the system is isolated, its total energy U is a constant. Therefore, U equals to sigma NIEI is constant. Consider an isolated gas containing N molecules in a container at a certain temperature and pressure. The total energy of the system remains constant. But the molecules of a gas collide with each other and also with the walls of the container due to their random motion. As a result, the energies of molecules will be continuously changing. In other words, of molecules, N1 having energy E1 will be changing. The number of molecules N2 having energy E2 will be changing and so on. This shows that the values of N1, N2, N3, etc. are continuously changing. The total energy U remains same for the isolated system. It can be reasonably assumed that for each microscopic state of a system of particles, there exists a particular most favored distribution. This distribution is likely to occur than others. This distribution is called as most probable distribution. When this distribution is reached, the system attains statistical equilibrium. For an isolated system, the values N1, N2, N3, so on vary only near the values corresponding to this most probable distribution. The basic problem in statistical thermodynamics is to obtain the most probable distribution law for a given position of system. In practice, the most probable distribution laws are Maxwell-Boltzmann distribution law, Fermi-Dirac distribution law, Bose-Einstein distribution law. Next is concept of probability. The probability of an event may be defined as the ratio of the number of cases in which the event occurs to the total number of cases, provided the total number of cases is very large. The probability of an event equals to number of cases in which the event occurs divided by total number of cases. Consider that
An event occur in A ways and failed to occur in B ways. Then the probability of happening the event equals to A divided by A plus B. Probability of failing the event equals to B by A plus B. Here it is assumed that A plus B ways have the same chance of occurrence. The sum of two probabilities is however 1, because the event may either occur or fail. Let there be four boys A, B, C, D who want to get a particular red ball. The probability of getting A red ball is 1/4. Similarly, let there be another green ball which is distributed among the four boys. The probability of A getting again the green ball is 1/4. Thus, the probability of A getting both the balls simultaneously is 1/16. Therefore, the probability of composite event is equal to the product of probabilities of individual and independent events. Boltzmann distribution law. Maxwell Post distribution law is one of the important distribution laws in classical statistics. This statistics is applied to all identical particles which are distinguishable. Consider a system of n similar but distinguishable molecules of a gas contained in a vessel. The gas molecules are moving freely within the vessel in all possible directions. At a certain temperature, the entire gas has a certain average energy, but the different gas molecules have different energies. In 1854, Maxwell considered that how a fixed total amount of energy is distributed among the various members of an assembly. The expression concerning this idea is known as Maxwell-Boltzmann distribution law. Suppose there are n molecules in an assembly. Out of n molecules, let small n1 have energy E1, n2 have energy E2, n3 have energy E3, and so on. Let the energy be limited to k values. So the entire assembly of molecules may be divided into different energy states with energies E1, E2, so on up to Ek. When having N1, N2, so on up to Nk molecules. As the total number of gas molecules is N and also the total energy E of gas molecules is constant, we have the following relations. For consideration of particles N1 plus N2 plus so on up to Nk equals to summation Ni equals to capital N. For conservation of energy, N1 E1 plus N2 E2 plus Nk so on up to Nk Ek equals to summation Ni Ei, that is capital E. Considering that a priori probability of a molecule to have energy Ei is Gi, Maxwell-Boltzmann derived the relation Ni equals to Gi into e power minus alpha into e power minus beta alpha minus beta Ei. Here e power minus alpha and beta are constants. The result determines the probable distribution of molecules among various energy states and is known as Maxwell distribution law. Now, according to the above equation, the number of molecules per cell decreases exponentially with energy Ei associated with the cell. This means that low energy cell will contain more particles than high energy cell. The number of particles being maximum in zero energy cell. The variation of Ni with Ei is shown in figure. Next is application of this law to an ideal gas. Let us consider an assembly of n molecules of an ideal gas contained in a volume V at absolute temperature T. Let us apply Maxwell-Boltzmann distribution law to obtain the number of molecules with energies between E and E plus dE in the ideal gas.
According to Maxwell Boltzmann distribution law, we have Ni equals to Gi into e power minus alpha into e power minus beta Ei, where e power minus alpha and beta are constants. In order to evaluate e power alpha and beta, it is convenient to consider a continuous distribution of energies rather than a discrete set of E1, E2, so on up to Er. From above equation, n of e dE equals to g of e into e power minus alpha into e power minus beta e dE, where n of e dE represents the number of molecules having energies between e and e plus dE. We know that e equals to p square by 2m, where p is molecular momentum. Therefore, the above equation can be written as n of p dp equals to g of p e power alpha e power beta minus beta p square by 2m dp, where n of p dp represents the number of molecules having momenta between p and p plus dp. The values of e power alpha and beta are given as e power alpha equals to capital N into H cube by V into beta by 2 pi m whole power 3 by 2, where H is Planck's constant and m is the mass of the molecule. Beta equals to 1 by kT, where K is Boltzmann constant. Further, the value of G of P, a priori probability for an ideal gas, is given by G of P equals to 4 pi V P square by H cube. Substituting the values, n of p dp equals to 4 pi v p square by h cube into n h cube by v into 1 by 2 pi m kt by whole power 3 by 2 into e power minus p square by 2 m kt dp. Therefore, n of p dp equals to 4 pi n into 1 by 2 pi m kt whole power 3 by 2 into p square into e power minus p square by 2 m kt dp. Since p square equals to 2 m e and dp equals to m dE by under root 2 m e, therefore, n of e dE equals to 2 pi n into 1 by pi kT whole power 3 by 2 into e power 1 by 2 into e power minus e by kT into dE. This equation gives the number of molecules with energies between e and e plus dE in an ideal gas containing n molecules at absolute temperature T. This is called Maxwell-Boltzmann distribution of energies. Average molecular energy. The average molecular energy can be obtained with the help of the above equation. The total energy of the system is given by U equals to integral 0 to infinity E into N of E dE. That is integral 0 to infinity 2 pi n into 1 by pi kT into whole power 3 by 2 into e power 3 by 2 into e power minus e by kT dE. By solving that, we get 3 by 2 n kT. The average energy per molecule is given by U equals to U by n, that is 3 by 2 kT. Distribution of molecular speeds in an ideal gas. To obtain Maxwell-Boltzmann distribution law of molecular speeds, we substitute E equals to half mv square and dE equals to mv dv. We know that n of e dE equals to n of v dV. Using that, n of v dV equals to 2 pi n into 1 by pi kT whole power 3 by 2 into half mv square whole power half into e power minus mv square by 2 kT into mv dV. Therefore, n of v dV equals to 4 pi n into m by 2 pi kT whole power 3 by 2 into v square into e power minus m v square by 2 kT into dV. This equation represents the number of molecules with the speeds between V and V plus dV in an ideal gas having n molecules at temperature capital T. This is known as Maxwell-Boltzmann distribution of speeds. For small values of V, the exponential term e power minus mv square by 2 kt is nearly equal to unity. So the number of molecules with the speed v, that is n of v, is proportional to v square. For large values of v, the exponential term dominates over v square. In this case, n of v is proportional to e power minus mv square by 2 kt. Thus, if we plot a graph between n of v against v, the speed distribution function first rises parabolically, reaches a maximum, and then falls exponentially. Probability function p of v. The fraction of molecules having speeds between v and v plus dv is given by n of v dv divided by capital N. That is 4 pi into m by 2 pi kt whole power 3 by 2 into v square into e power minus m v square by 2 kt into dv. By definition, n of v dv by n represents the probability that a molecule will have speed between v and v plus dv. P of v, v dv equals to 4 pi m by 2 pi kt whole power square into e power minus mv square by 2 kt into dv. The probability function p of v is defined as the probability that a molecule will possess speed v. Hence, p of v equals to 4 pi into m by 2 pi kt whole power 3 by 2 into v square into e power minus mv square by 2 kt.